Pulse Live from the point of Saginaw, Washington, on streets in beautiful downtown Durand, Michigan. First Congregational Church presents Cafe Devo, a five-minute devotion that fits seamlessly into your day with an encouraging biblical thought designed to lift your spirit and point you to Jesus Christ. Thanks for clicking the start button. God bless you. Welcome to this Tuesday episode of Cafe Devo. It's December 26th here in beautiful downtown Durand, Michigan. I'm your host, Pastor Steve Wood. You all know my pal Bugsy. He's hanging out over there where he usually does. And I hope your Tuesday is going well. I hope you're kicking back and relaxing on this day after Christmas. Maybe you're still celebrating. Maybe you got family plans for today. If so, I hope they are wonderful. And thank you for joining me. I hope our time together will be a blessing to you. Once again today, we return to the book Truth for Life, a series of devotions written by Pastor Alistair Begg and collected in two volumes. Volume 2 is copyright 2022, The Good Book Company. Matthew 2, 4 and 5. He inquired of them where Christ was to be born. They told him in Bethlehem of Judea, for so it is written by the prophet. When Jesus was born, 7 centuries after the prophet Micah had predicted where he would appear, his arrival was met with a variety of reactions, and those responses are much the same today as they were then. Some were hostile, some were indifferent, some, however, responded in faith. King Herod was the epitome of hostility toward Jesus. He stands for everyone who says to themselves, I don't mind some religious person sitting quietly in the back seat, but I don't want anybody driving the car of my life. A religious leader who keeps quiet is acceptable. One who makes claims on a person's life and does not agree with what they already think is not. Herod did all he could do to ensure there would be no king to rival him, Matthew 2, 16 through 18. And many people do today. Jerusalem's religious professionals responded to the arrival of Jesus with indifference. When Herod asked them about the coming of the Christ, they were able to answer his questions, and they were able to be specific. They were aware that Micah had prophesied that the Messiah would be born in Bethlehem, but they simply didn't care. If they had, they would have been out looking for him themselves. They would not even take the time to make a 6-mile journey to meet and worship the newly born, long-awaited King of the Jews. They completely disregarded him. They were too busy with their religion and their traditions to make time for their rescuing King. Then there were the wise men. This group of foreign astrologers who saw a star in the heavens, worked out what it was announcing, and packed their bags and came looking for Jesus in faith. What moved these men, who were the authorities in their field, to bow down at the cradle of an infant? How does that happen? Only by the power of God. And it was they, not Herod, not the priests, who were the ones who rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. You see, there's only one true dividing line between people. It has nothing to do with skin color or intellect or social status or even politics. It is the dividing line between unbelief, whether that unbelief manifests itself as hostility or indifference, and belief. We may note that the Western world grows in hostility to a God who insists on ruling the world that he created. But we should also note that there are plenty of people claiming to be Christian who are at risk of unbelief, the unbelief of indifference. They no longer practice their faith. Those of us who have heard this wonderful Christmas story countless times, who know our Old Testaments and our New Testaments, who are in church Sunday by Sunday, are not immune to the indifference that is seen in a lack of joy over the Lord and a lack of response to His Word when it calls us to change our plan. And whoever we are, if we won't have Jesus as king in this life, we won't live in his kingdom in the other. If you choose to ask Christ to leave you alone, either in your hostility or in your indifference, he will leave you alone forever. Your response to Jesus has eternal significance. Look to him who came to die for hostile and indifferent sinners. Then allow his great love to soften your heart so that you respond to him in real, joyful, obedient faith today and then every day after. For more on this, turn to the book of Matthew in the New Testament and read chapter 2, verses 1 through 11. Father, we're grateful for the Tuesday that you've given us, for the gift of life, and may we be mindful of you today, Father. Let us not grow hostile or indifferent. Let us not cover ourselves over in being good people. Let us look to you. Help us today, Father, to come face to face with you, to rejoice at your presence, and to follow you willingly. We make our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, that'll do it for us on this Tuesday edition of Cafe Devo. Thanks so much for spending a little time with me. I'm Pastor Steve Wood, signing off for now. God bless you, my friends.